strong passed pawn on c5. But I have a pawn on e3.
So this is
easily winning.
Here.
G5, I think I played. Yeah, here. And resign. So. I think. Okay, we have time for one last game. Sacrifice
now. In the final position before the ending, you said it's a draw with rook h4. The previous analysis.
With the
last position. When the
ending.
King is cut off.
Yes.
Yes, with the king e6, I think.
E6?
E6, yes.
Okay, I don't have it.
Yes. If I check rook d4, what happens? And then kick king f6, f6.
Yes.
This is a well-known draw, the rook.
Maybe here.
From in front.
I'm not so sure.
Isn't it dukes on later?
Maybe. Endings are always tricky.
No, just king c3.
King c3 works.
King d5.
Fine.
It's now rook to h1. Must be drawn.
Yes.
This is important, the rook from in front, not from behind, when the king is cut off.
Yeah.
If we can.
Could also this. Ah, no, this is cut. Okay, no. Okay.
If we can push e4. Before.
Right. When, if you push, you usually end up. Okay, let's say a play here. Yes.
And now it's ready. Rook A3.
Okay,
rook
this is.
Draw.
Yes. But also, this is probably draw. And king coming. Okay, this is.
Okay.
Technique is always a bit tricky.
For grandmaster, it is easy, but for.
No, it's not even easy for me. I can never remember anything. This time I'm white. It was played in 2007. It was a European team championship against Germany. I was playing Kritz. So, knight c6. Four takes, takes. Six, I guess. No, queen b6. Knight b3. What?
Grievous is in there.
I don't know. E6. Knight c3, I guess. He played queen c7 back already. Here. I don't know much about theory, I have to say. But. So now my plan is to push on e5 sooner or later. Bishop e7, bishop d2. And now this interesting move. He wants somehow to bring the knight here. I don't really know the theories. A1. C5. Now, all I can say is that this is also interesting, with the idea to play E5. Clear the E4 square for the knight and the diagonal for the bishop. But I was not so afraid of him taking on C3, so I think I play King H1. He did take, and I took with the pawn. This happens quite many times, and now we have the C file and good center. He has the bishop pair, but it's not so easy to use. I can push my center. Now, probably the best move is to play here, just to control a few squares, but keep it here. And now, maybe you can suggest a move.
Knight
B5. Yes. Let's go. I remember I was thinking for a long time on knight d5 when what happens, and then I really thought, let's go. I just played and see what happens. He played here. Actually, the computer sort of suggested this is the best move. You know. And unfortunately, now I have a forced win, which I believe is this one. As you notice, I can never win the first time. I always have to play a little longer. Here, knight d4. F6. Take here. G6. I'm sure I saw this far. But now, unfortunately, the machine sees one more move, and it's this one. Bit strange. Before, only move. And you know, positional chess. He's changed the only good piece which he has. Take. And resign. Because now all the squares are too weak. But okay, you understand this was not so easy to find.
When it comes to E5 and
Queen E5, yes. Queen E5. Computer says this is the best move, so you understand. It was not so obvious, and I have the move I played is also fine. This is very direct. Okay, I bring my knight to the center. Okay, he plays probably the best move, at least defending, so now I don't have any trick like this. But okay, so then playing positional chess. Now, f6 is also becoming a threat, so he decided to stop it. There is not really much he can play. For instance, I was analyzing some move like h6. It's sort of desperate. Okay, let's just see what happens. I think I'll check. So now he kind of castle. If the knight goes here...
Knight e6,
yes. And take everything, yes. So here. And now again, simple. The rook is coming to g4, or, you know, leaving space for the other one. Okay, there are a few possible moves, but basically white is winning. Bishop d7. Rook e1, bring all the pieces, bishop e8, I'm careful, so, now I have this funny variation, here, and now I give this move, I'm not so sure it's quite old analysis, h3, it's probably just, but it's very funny to play such move when your opponent has nothing to do. Okay, he played a bit more human than King F7. Probably this was the computer's first line.
Five.
He played here, quite sure of that here. Yes. Okay, some attack here and especially here. So now he played here, which is probably not the best defense. Queen c7 is better. And now this is winning.
Not a5.
Not to a5. Because this is take, take, take. Oh. And I'm waiting for him to play here, and now this is over. Because it's also check. Okay, maybe bishop a5 was winning. Also. I don't know. Keep it here. I was happy to jump, finally. Take, take. Rook is hanging. This one. Resign. This was my last open Sicilian, I think.
So, if you could tell us, lots of Greek players, amateurs, I mean, at the level of 2000 and 2100, study a lot of openings. And you said that you played against a grandmaster from Germany, a very solid grandmaster, and you said, I knew nothing about the other position.
Well, okay. Knowing nothing is a bit different. I mean, I knew the general ideas. I had analyzed a few games I had played before. I used to be an e4 player, so I had some experience. But okay, I don't really like theory so much, and remembering variation, I'm a bit more creative when I can.
So can you give an advice to the Greek players?
Yes, advice is to enjoy chess and look at games. It's more fun than theory. And try to play well. If you play well, you just sacrifice and it may happen. Yes. Because you also knew some theory, I guess. But, you know, I bring the pieces to the center. I try to make some logical plan with the push on e5. Then suddenly I get my opportunity to play knight e5 and I do it. I guess this is also what the very good players do. They know the theory, and but it's most important, they find their own way to play.
To say something more about this question, I usually tell to young players to try to persuade them not to study too much theory, opening that you have no, you have not win games from the theory. You can
yes. You can have winning position, but sometimes you don't win.
A little plus, or, yes. But nothing more. You must play chess after to win.
Yes. I'm not really a theory fan, but this is also a weakness.
For your level. I mean for, yes. I mean for weaker players.
Yes. Because I think it's also more fun to look at games.
There's a general perception that the grandmaster knows lots of theory.
Whole I think I don't. I know some, of course, but I like to play my chess.
Thank you very much for
Welcome.